Well, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Before I speak about this, I have to speak about the Ghurfa. You know, we are really, all the Arab chambers of commerce and the whole Arab world are really very proud of Al Ghurfa. And the reason, I think it's the most active joint chamber of commerce between the Arab and the other countries is the Arab-German Chamber of Commerce called Ghurfa. Since this was established nearly, at least before 25 years, it was the most effective joint venture between the Arab world and the other countries especially. Ghurfa today is playing an important role in the, even in the political relationship between the Arab world and Germany. And it's very much, very strongly supported by quite a number of German leaders, German business people. And the result of that cooperation now, we see the increase of the private sector in the Arab world in the investment in Germany. And the exchange of trade has really doubled nearly 10 times in the last 10 to 15 years. That's right. So that's when I speak about the Ghurfa, it's really something to talk about. Today, the leading of the Ghurfa, when I speak about Dr. Ramzauer or Mr. Al-Bukhafi, they are really the key who played a very important role for that thing. When I come to the energy problem, certainly it's important. I don't think you find any other place to really support such an idea as the Ghurfa, the German Arab German. Because today when I see the participants in this, they're all the top German and even the top Arab companies. I am sure it's going to give a very, very positive results for both sides. I'm sure after that thing, I'm sure you will see a lot of German companies taking part in auto projects in the Arab world, and vice versa, you find more investment in this sector in Germany. Well, let's be with you. Today, clean energy is the future. If I start with automotive, which is, I hear a lot again that within the coming 5 years, there will be at least 60% of cars in the whole world will be clean energy. In different, you know, section. When I speak about between the possibilities now, today, you know, in the Arab world, they have quite the sun, and there is nearly 80% of the time is sunny, you know, and that means this will be very attractive for solar energy. And this had already started. There are some projects, even with German companies, in Saudi Arabia, in Kuwait, in the Emirates, in other countries. But this is the start. I feel really because of the climate is so clean, so clear for the future, and we'll see maybe in a very short time that a lot of this energy had increased in between Germany and the Arab world. Well, it's a good question. You know, it's not only in the energy. I'm also wishing and hoping that there will be a common joint venture between the Arab companies and German companies in both sectors. Joint venture in Germany and joint venture in the Arab world and joint venture even outside Germany, outside the Arab world. In China, for example, we had already started some joint venture between German companies and some Arab companies. I think my wish really this subject will be very much increased because it's really the future for the German-Arab business relationship. Well, the most important thing in any business is the trust and relationship between them. Today, I will be speaking very openly and very frankly. The whole Arab world have very, very big trust in Germany. And that comes because we feel all Germany, if you are German or non-German, there is the law. Respect the law in Germany, you have nothing difference. And they affect really Germany. Even if you come with any investment in Germany, they will treat you as if you are a German because according to the German law. And this is something very important. And that's why we see in Kuwait, for example, today the private sector investment in Germany had reached over 15 billion euro. And the reason was because the confidence and trust in Germany.